Greetings, guys, gals, and non-binary pals, and welcome back to another video. I hope that you are well, and I hope that you are fighting, because there is a lot to be fighting for. As usual, there'll be a link in the description to the page on my website with a bunch of petitions, donations, emails to send to MPs, etc, etc. And just a reminder, those are updated every couple of weeks, so if you've already gone and signed everything, if you come back every few weeks, there might be some more things for you to sign, because there's a lot of things happening all the time. So today's video, I'm going back to an old favorite of mine, one that you keep asking for a part two of, so I thought that I would deliver, and that is going through r/menwritingwomen, because it's really, it's terrible, it's hilarious, and it's terrible, and I just wanted to have a bit of a laugh with you, have a little bit of a talk about it, so that is what we are going to be doing today. Would a male author describe your breasts as small but persistent, bountiful but unimaginative, stern but not without charm, perky and non-judgmental, shy but good listeners, robust and welcoming, or shriveled and dusty to the touch? The way that it's so accurate. To answer the question, I think that it would probably be barely there but intriguing. That's how a male author would just... That's how a male author would describe my boobs, I think. But, you know, I feel like maybe they shouldn't be describing boobs at all. It's unimportant and adds absolutely nothing to the story. So maybe leave them alone. Maybe just don't be explaining people's boobs. Especially young people. Like, male authors will often include description of, like, children's bodies. And it's really weird, really messed up. Please do not be doing that. Thank you. She was the perfect picture of a beautiful Japanese girl. Small feet, small nose, wide eyes, narrow hips that showed she was a virgin. Because the touch of a man is enough to change a person's entire bone structure. Sir, where did you go to school? Where did this idea come from? Please explain how that makes sense at all. You think the touch of a man changes a person's bone structure? It just like shifts their pelvis. That's a waitress who was moderately pretty but wore too much makeup set his steaming cappuccino on the table and grinned. Anything else? No, thank you, he added blatantly. How is that necessary to the story? Like I said before, I just don't understand why people just decide to sprinkle in misogyny for absolutely no reason at all. Like, why did you need to comment on how much makeup the waitress was wearing? It adds nothing to the story. This man was just like, yes, I need women to know that they should not be wearing too much makeup because I find it unappealing. So I'm going to write it into my story. Just shut up. Just leave it alone. Too much makeup? If you can leave it out of the story, then leave it out of the story. Things should not be put in that are absolutely unnecessary. Women exist to be attractive to me, and the waitress wasn't attractive to me because she wore too much makeup, so I was a bit rude to her. Unimportant. Unimportant. Leave it out. Just give it a miss, man. Just give it a miss. The greatest thing that this pandemic has taught us is just how far society has fallen from masculinity. The feminization of society has turned the majority of people into easily manipulated, accepting morons who aren't just lazy physically, mentally, and emotionally, but more so spiritually. And yes, being lazy is a feminine trait. So is making up excuses and getting easily offended. Masculinity will prevail, and men like Pallister, Bowman, and Rowson will soon be removed from power along with all the women that support their bullshit. It's about time men start acting like men. Bro, just say you hate women and move on. I don't know where this notion of men aren't men comes from. Who decided what being a man is? You realize that that has changed so many times throughout history. And for a very large part of history, men owned women. Like, men were owners. Men owned people. Is that what you think makes a man? Because if that's what you think makes a man, please lock yourself in your room and never ever come out. What makes a man, and why do you get to dictate that? Well, men can't wear dresses because I don't think that that's manly enough. Who cares? You know, men have worn dresses all throughout history and still do in so many places in the world, as I said a few videos back. And then it's like, men have to be strong physically. That's what makes you a man. So if you're not lifting weights, you're not a man. Why? Who decided that? I just want to know who decided what being a man is. It's changed so many times throughout history, and I don't know why so many people are stuck in this way of like, no, this is what a man is, and we are not allowed to adapt or grow or change from this point. Because all of humanity has been growing and adapting throughout the... How long have humans been alive? Throughout the tens of thousands of years that humans have existed, we have grown and evolved. If we never changed the way that we acted and viewed the world and each other, we'd still be living in caves and hitting each other with rocks. Why are so many people on the right so against change and growth? That is what life is about. That is what everything is about. Literally, not that long ago, people were slave owners. Women were property. We've realized that that was a bit messed up. Yeah, like very, very messed up. We're all freaking human beings. And we've grown and changed and adapted. And now even a lot of people on the right admit, yeah, that's a bit fucked up. We shouldn't own people. But back in the day, that was considered a very liberal left view. Just adapt. Society evolves, and if it didn't, we would be cavemen. Stop dictating what humans can and can't do based on what's normal. And also, maybe the reason men don't get offended as easily is because people don't go out of their way to offend men. Men aren't discriminated against. Men aren't oppressed for being men. It's easier to offend a woman or upset a woman because you're being blatantly misogynistic, which is terrible. Also, you sound pretty offended by the idea of men not being men. So maybe sit down, sir. Calm down. Stop calling. There's so much. Listen. She was as tall as any man could ask for. Her breasts hidden by her dress were perky, tantalizing people wherever she went. Her long legs were admired by just as many men, even called art by some. Her waist was so thin that one could wrap their hands around it and almost touch their fingers together. Because a woman's existence is only as important as the male attention and approval she receives, right? Within this writing, the common overall theme is how a man feels about her is her character. It's got nothing to do with her or who she is. It's how a man sees her and views her. And it's constant objectification and it's always focused around her body, which is so unimportant. I've never seen a man write a man like that. You don't see men writing like, his nipples were liars. You don't see a man writing, I could tell he was lying based on the way his nipples were erect. Never, never. You will never see a man write that about a man, but you will see them write it constantly about women. It's unimportant to the story and they know that. It's just weird and creepy. Please stop it. If it doesn't need to be there, don't put it there, okay? Oh, in that way, may I hold your hand for a minute? He asked, suddenly fixing his eyes on her with almost hypnotic power and sending out an appeal that affected her directly in the womb. Sir. What? Sending out an appeal that directly affected her in the womb. What does that even mean? Does he think when a woman is attracted to a man, we feel it in our womb? I don't know where you went to school, but maybe you should go back to a different one. Maybe not the one you came from, but I think you should go back to a school. Go back to biology, because what? That's not how any of this works. You don't feel anything ever in your womb other than terrible pain when you're having your period or when there's a baby in it. Other than that, you don't, there's no pleasant feeling that comes from your womb. I guess that's what I was trying to... Womb, that's a gross word. I don't like it. John, yeah? You were checking me out when I was leaning over the seat, weren't you? He found himself blushing. It's okay. After a high-stress situation, men usually think that way. I wasn't insulted. I just want you to know it's normal. It might bother you later, you know, given you should be worried about your girl, memories of your wife and such. This is straight up a man just trying to justify his actions. Writing it into the book doesn't make it true. Writing it down does not make it real. That's not how facts work, sir. I'm not bothered by it. Bro, if you're staring down my shirt, I'm gonna be bothered by it. And I think a majority of women will be. Stop trying to justify your shitty actions by writing it down in a book that you share with people. Like I said, that doesn't make it a real thing. Keep your eyes to yourself. You can admire people and think that they're beautiful, but there is a line that you cross. When you're looking down someone's shirt, that's a line. There's a difference between admiring and objectifying. Yeah, you can look at someone and go, wow, she's beautiful. But the line is when you look at someone like, wow, I want to fuck her. That's the line, you know? You don't cross it. Stop sexualizing women, please and thank you. From every woman everywhere. It makes you uncomfortable. I'm not consenting to being sexualized. My body is not sexual unless it's in a sexual context, okay? That's like a rule. Bodies are sexual when they are meant to be, but they aren't when they're not. That's the difference. It's like with Free the Nipple, right? Boobs are not inherently sexual. Nipples are not inherently sexual. They can be in the right context, but they're not. You know what I mean? And I've said this before, like with feet. Feet are not a sexual part of your body. However, some people have like foot fetishes, and then in certain situations, your feet can be sexual. It's all about consent and situation. My body is not sexual unless I am explicitly telling you that this is a sexual situation and you are also consenting to that. So objectifying and sexualizing me when I am not telling you that that is okay, that is not okay. Does that make sense? I think it does. Stop sexualizing women. That's the overall thing. Also, don't sexualize men or non-binary people. Just don't sexualize people without their explicit consent that that is okay. Okay? Great. Moving on. Accurate representation of periods. Oh yeah, but it's nothing compared to the pain and sacrifice that our troops have felt for our country. They fought for your right to bleed and spend money on overpriced feminine products. So be thankful and stand for the flag and anthem, please. Did you know that people who menstruate are also in the troops, firstly? So they're experiencing both menstrual cramps and fighting for your country. Secondly, are you implying that if the troops weren't out there fighting, periods wouldn't exist? They're fighting for your right to bleed. So if they weren't fighting, we wouldn't have the right to bleed? What would happen? Would we get arrested when we're on our period? What does that mean? What does that mean? Does it mean if the troops stop fighting, we'll stop having our periods? Or does it mean if they stop fighting, we don't have the right to bleed anymore? The one thing you did get right, though, is that period products are overpriced. I 100% agree with you. But why are the troops fighting for them to be overpriced? That's another thing I don't understand. I don't think that that is at all what they're doing at all. I don't think anyone's fighting to keep period products overpriced. And again, I go back to the question, does that mean if they stop fighting, period products will no longer be overpriced? But then if they stop fighting and it meant we no longer got our periods, then they wouldn't be overpriced because we wouldn't need them because we wouldn't... I don't understand the logic. I don't quite understand how the two are related at all, but go off, I guess. Okay, well, I think that's enough of that. I hope that you've been entertained by just men lacking knowledge about women and also having absolutely no interest in wanting to learn. Because they're gonna continue writing like this. We all know they're gonna continue writing like this. Let me know if you want me to do another one of these, because I think they're quite fun. A massive thank you to all my KiwiFruit channel members whose names are up on the screen right now. And a big thank you to my channel member of the day, Paula. I love and appreciate you so, so much. Thank you so much for joining. If you would like to become a channel member, you can press the top link in the description or the little blue join button. You get my videos a day early as well as 10% off my merch, which is available at thequeerkiwi.com/shop. If you would like to grab some of that, I would really appreciate that. Don't forget to drop a like and subscribe. I am here every few days and I would love if you came and hung out with me again, because I enjoy hanging out with you. Follow me on Instagram, TheQueerKiwi, and Twitter, ThatQueerKiwi. I hope that you enjoy the rest of your day. Stay safe. Keep fighting. I love you. Mwah!